Good afternoon and welcome to our webinar for RenoNC. I'm Cristina Fumagalli from CIM System Marketing Team. Now I want to introduce you my colleague Andrea Iraghi.
Okay, hello everyone, I'm Andrea Iraghi. Welcome this is our webinar. Today we speak about our software CAM RenoNC. It's a plugin integrated, completely integrated in Reno Sales CAD. Today, I will show you the main function of RenoNC about milling modules, okay? And we create a simulation of a complete milling process on an example geometry, 3D, okay? And we create step by step from create the milling strategies, okay? To create a CNC file that we send to our milling. Okay, I remember you that at the end of this presentation, you can answer me question or more info about RenoNC directly. We go to webinar, okay, you can to write the answer directly on the GoTo webinar, or it's possible to send me an email in the next time, okay? Okay, let's go. Now, in my monitor, you see the classical RenoCeros interface, version 6, okay, this classical layout, okay. And inside this layout, there is also our RenoNC software. Our RenoNC software is possible to manage by this main bar, okay, when it's possible to manage or create a strategy, simulation, post-processor, and so on. Or if you want, it's possible to manage also with this tab, create this tree of strategy with the list of my strategy. Also, there is also this other secondary bar that is possible to manage, for example, all the archive, for example, the tool library or the machine library, the material, it's possible to manage the configuration of the RenoNC and our documentation, help, tutorial, and so on. Okay, so now we start to create our process, okay, on this simple 3D file. It's a very easy and simple mold, okay, and it's possible to start with create a new operation, okay. We can to manage all with this main bar. At the moment, you see that in this bar is possible to select only this icon for create a new operation. The other command is disabled because at the moment we started from zero and I don't have either any strategy to manage. So we create a new operation, okay, select this. I put the name of this operation, for example, we try to start with a roughing, you know, 3D roughing, okay. I'll select the name, for example, roughing one, okay. And here, there are all the modules present in my license because RenoNC is a modulable software, okay. And it's possible to select, for example, in this case, the milling module is possible to have the drilling machine, the machine strategy on a curve, okay. Or the machine strategy of the surface or solid in 3D, or the advanced machining surface for 5-axis machine tool. Okay, for example, in this case, I select directly surface machining for creating my roughing. Okay, and compare my wizard. This is our wizard. Then I put inside all my parameters for creating my strategy. This wizard is a create step by step, okay? For example, in this case, the first windows, I can to select the kind of strategy on my surface. For example, now I select roughing, okay? And go directly in the second step, in the second windows, okay? Here, we start with the main parameter for creating a strategy. For example, the raw part is possible to select the start stock to mill, okay. I have three different possibility to create these, okay. It's possible to have by limits, okay. The initial stock in this case, I will the maximum area respect the finish part, okay? Or it's possible to select from geometry inside a layer, inside the Reno Seros, okay? Like for example, my project, okay? Or it's possible to select also worked model if this strategy starts from the rest material to other roughing created before, okay? In this case, in my process, I select the raw part layer from raw part layer. Other main program here, this is a roughing with the Z level increment, and so it's possible to put inside the Z step length increment, for example, 3 millimeter, okay, and the lateral increment. In this case, it's possible to put inside the value with the percentual respect to the diameter of my tool, for example, in this case, 50%. An option very interesting here is this. When I put inside my mouse inside the Windows, here compare the an image, okay, that explained very easy, very well, the kind of value that I stay at the moment. Okay, this is very good when the customer start to learn the software, and is a very good help for to know very well RenoC in a very fast time. Other parameter very important, we have there is a Z clearance plane, the safety plane on the top of my part, okay, and the Z approach distance. When the movement change from rapid movement to work movement, when go on my part, it's possible, for example, to put inside also the angle of ramp if in my part there are some close pocket, and in this case the tool go not in vertical directly, but it's possible to select a ramp for entry with this kind of movement. It's possible to inside also the offset type, the oversize, for example, in this case is a roughing, so it's possible to put inside 1 millimeter of offset for oversize, and it's possible to have a kind of oversize global, okay, and we have 1 millimeter for all my surface, okay, or it's possible to select different oversized material, for example, respect on a wall or respect on the plane. Okay, in our approach, it's possible to select directly global. So now in this window, it's possible to also select the delimitation of the area. So, for example, the Z limit, if you put automatic my toolpath strategy work all my part, but if you want to stop it before or in other value, my Z limit is possible to select the user defined, okay, and select the Z maximum and minimum with a value, or directly with this icon select one point directly on my geometry inside the Rhinoceros interface, okay. In the same time, it's possible to delimitation also an area, okay, respect a closed curve, okay, select a closed curve directly on my geometry, or directly select by mouse with a selection like a windows, okay. In this case, in my project, I want to milling all my parts, so I leave automatic. Here it's possible to have other options, for example, closed option offset. In this case, like in this image, it's possible to change the kind of movement when I work, for example, in this case, in an open pocket, in the part of that we don't have any surface, it's possible to move with a work movement at the same Z level, or work with a rapid movement, another kind of movement. This is possible to select before, depends of the kind of your mini machine, the kind of tool, or the kind of material, and so on. So when I finish and put all my parameter, go with this button in the next page, in the next windows, okay, or if you want to save this strategy and complete in a second time. Now we go in the second page on my wizard. In this case, I can select my tool. So now it's possible to select a different kind of tool, flat tool, ball tool, toric, conical tool, tool for with the engumbrance with a different diameter, or a tool with undersquare part, and so on. For example, in this case, we go to select the toric, cylindrical toric tool, okay, and put our diameter, for example, 16, and the radius on the corner, for example, 2 millimeter. Other option, for example, in this case, the option for a technological parameter, the spindle speed, the different feed rate, if you want to use the coolant or the kind of coolant or not, is options. So in this case, I can to leave my strategy without this parameter, and I can to calculate my toolpad without this, or improve with this parameter and to have also this parameter inside my final post-processor file, okay? The tool is possible to select also from our archive. It's possible to select a tool inside my archive, or it's possible to save this tool that I create now, add directly here in my archive, okay? So, we go in the last windows, okay, that in this case the last window is the work plane when I want to create my zero part zero coordinate system, okay. This is very important because in RhinoC it's possible to create the other work plane completely different respect the work plane in Rhinoceros, because this is very important, because if you don't want to translate or move your parts, but we want to create a toolpath without another work plane, it's possible to put inside here. For example, in this case, if I iconize my strategy, okay, in this case my work plane is here in the center of my part at the bottom, okay, but for example I want to create another zero part on the top of my parts. So I come back in my strategy, okay, create a new work plane, and I can put a name, for example, work plane number one. And it's possible to edit this and change the position. For example, it's possible to change to insert a value in X, Y, or Z axis, or it's possible with this button to select directly on my geometry my zero part, or it's possible to select, for example, like in this window, it's possible if you, for example, don't know the measure of my part, but I want to select the maximum Z level, maximum Z level value, and in the center of my part, click only in this part, okay? And automatically I have the change in my position. Or if you have four or five axis machine, it's possible also to change the orientation on my Z axis, and so my tool, respect, for example, perpendicular to a surface, perpendicular to a curve, or for example, directly perpendicular of your point of view of your monitor. Okay, in this case, I select and I create my new zero part work plane, and I can to select or save my strategy or directly calculate my strategy. Okay, so now you see my new work plane. Okay, and at the end of my calculation, I have here my toolpath. In a red movement is a work movement, and in a white movement, the rapid movement. Okay, now when I finished my calculation, in my main bar, compare the enable the other icon, the other command, and here there is a list of my strategy. Okay, so for example, before to continue our process, for example, for my roughing, I don't want to work, for example, in this area, okay, because I want to, I prefer to mill with other strategy and so on. So it's possible to come back in my strategy. For example, I can to click with the right mouse directly on my my roughing directly in this list, okay, right mouse, I come back directly in my wizard, okay. Here is possible to change parameter, oversize, all. And for example, here is possible to select and change my part in this area. So double click on my wizard and iconize my wizard, okay. Now I have the possibility to use all the Rhinoceros CAD command. So for example, in this case, I came to create a flat surface here. So for example, I create a loft surface from this board, this board to this. Okay. Create also in the other side here. Okay, and here. Okay. Now, possible to come back in my strategy and directly in automatic recalculate all my roughing. Okay, in this case, the strategy recognizes the new surface and check this, and the result is this. Okay, I have the strategy on this without this area. Okay, so for example, now we can to simulate with the second icon my toolpath directly in a Rhinoceros interface. We have there are three kinds of strategy. For example, the first is the strategy where I see my tool and if you want my toolpath and that go around my toolpath, okay. And it is possible to, for example, for this bar to manage, for example, I have the possibility to see, for example, the coordinate point at the moment. Is possible to go or return block by block. Okay. Here I go. I see the kind of movement G1 or G0, depending if it's a rapid movement or work movement, and the feed rate in this block. The other option, for example, in this simulation, if in a roughing, for example. It's possible to change the speed of my simulation, like this bar, okay, or change directly and move my tool directly on my toolpath, okay. For example, in this case, I want to check this point, but all my toolpath, it's very difficult because I have on video all my toolpath. So with this option, okay, it's possible to hidden all the other plane that I have just simulated, okay, and see only this plane, okay. And now it's possible to very easy to check to manage this, okay. Okay, the other kind of simulation, for example, the second kind of simulation is the simulation with the material remove, okay. The simulation, the bar is the same. I have my toolpath that in this case. Work directly on my material, okay, and it's possible to see all my material removed. For example, it's possible to go, okay, I have all my parts inside this, okay. So the other kind of simulation is normally used in 5-axis toolpath because it's possible to insert inside the simulation all the 3D of your milling machine, okay, and check all the dynamic element about this. Okay, so we continue our process. For example, it's possible to create a finishing of my part, but for example, I want to work, I want to mill only, for example, my shape here, okay, and so we have need to delimitation the area of my milling strategy. Okay, we go here, my bar, create another new operation, okay. For example, the name is finish one, and select also a strategy on the surface, okay. In this case, I select not roughing, okay, but finishing. For example, it's possible to select a constant cast finishing. It's very special strategy because in this case, the increment of my step is not in Z level or the lateral movement, but is directly projected on the surface. And so in this case, I have the very best quality and very uniform quality of all my surface. Okay. So in this case, I go in my wizard. Okay. Now I don't have my initial stock because it's a finishing strategy, but it's possible to select, for example, if we want to work all the surface of my parts, or it's possible to select directly each surface that I want to mill, or for example, in this case, it's possible to select by curve, and so it's possible to select a closed curve that is a delimitation of my area. For example, I put in my command, go in my Rhino-Cyrus interface and select, for example, my curve. In this case, it's a 3D curves. Okay. Confirm. Okay. And continue in my wizard, for example, to insert my step increment, for example, 2 millimeter. Okay. Select my oversized material. In this case, it's a finishing, so it's possible to put 0. Okay. And it's possible to change the Z approach distance, for example, 5 millimeter. Okay, and it's possible to change also the approach on this approach, the kind of movement that the tool uses when go on my parts. Okay, in this case, it's possible to go in the next page. Okay, I have to select my tool. Okay, in this case, for example, change the tool in a ball cylindrical tool, classical. Okay, and put inside, for example, 6 millimeter of diameter. Okay, go in my last windows, okay, that we have just to select automatic my work plane. It's okay, and so I calculate directly my toolpath. Okay, an option very, very important inside the RNC is a color of the strategy that comparing my tree. So for example, the roughing is a yellow, okay, the finish in this case is a black, and now is a yellow. The same is this in my bar. This is very important because when I have a black right, means that I create my strategy, but I don't have a calculator. Okay. If it is a yellow, I have a calculator also my toolpath, my strategy. And when I create also the post-processor file, I finish my process, okay, is a green. Okay, so I can to check always if my process is finished or not. Okay, for example, in this case, I create my calculated. Okay, my finishing calculated. For example, in this case, all the step is the same. For example, the wall on the plane. And now we have a very uniform quality of my finishing strategy. Okay. So, for example, another special strategy is for a drilling cycle machine. For example, in my part now, for example, I select my cover surface and hidden this. I want to drill, for example, this hole, okay? But I want to, in the same strategy, I want to drill also other hole with different orientation, okay? So, we create a new operation. Okay, create, for example, the name is a drilling number one. Okay, and select now other models, my drilling machine model. In RNC, there are two kinds of strategy for drilling machine. Okay, we have the simple strategy that I select my tool and I select my surface and okay, drill this. Instead is an automatic drilling machine. In this case, RNC recognize all the my cylinder, all my holes on inside my parts, my geometry, and automatic select all the diameter of the tool present in my archive, okay, and create and calculate all the drilling cycle for each kind of diameter, okay, in only one strategy. For example, it's possible also to create the simple drilling process. For example, if you have a cylinder and if you want to create a tap kind of drilling cycle, it's possible to create a centering before and the drilling and then the tapping, but directly in only one strategy with the three tools. Okay. In our process, in our geometry, it's possible to select directly the simple drilling machining strategy. Okay. Here in my wizard, it's possible to select my cycle, for example, drilling in this case. And for example, it's possible to select also all the options that it's possible to have. For example, I put inside here my safety plane, okay, the top of my part, and the approach distance, for example, 2 millimeter, okay. And here, inside here, it's possible to select with the geometry that you want to work, surface or cycle or curves, because this strategy is possible to use also from the 3D surface, okay, or also for a 2D simple circle curve, if you have to work the sample drawing 2D curve and so on, it's possible to select in this strategy. In this case, I have my surfaces, and so I select my surface directly. And now Rhino&C recognize in this list all the kind of diameter present in my parts. For example, in this case, I want to work all the diameter 5. Okay, you have also the different color because, for example, in this case, this is a blue surface and select diameter 5 and select directly in this case 2 surface. And for example, if we want to mill drilling also other cylinder, other hole, like for example diameter 5 black, okay, select directly this. In this case, in the same strategy, I have two different orientation of my geometry. Confirm this and come back in my wizard. Go in the next step. I select my tool, is the same to the other strategy. In this case, possible to select also all the kind of drilling tool, for example, twist drill. Okay, it's possible to put inside 5 millimeter of my diameter and the angle of my corner on my tool. Go in the other windows. In this case, you have the windows that is possible to select an option, a filter of my surface. For example, if I select, for example, 100 holes, it's possible to select if you want to work only the blind holes or, for example, also the passing holes. Okay, but this is very important, this option, axis orientation definition, because if you have, for example, a 3-axis machine, it's not possible directly in one strategy to mill both different orientation of my drilling. And so in this case, if you put here axis orientation definition, work only the holes that have axis of drilling same to Z axis. Okay, but if you put multi-axis drilling, okay, it's possible to automatically recognize all the orientation of my parts, of my holes. Okay, go on the next in the last page with my work plane. Okay, select my work plane and go calculate my strategy. Okay, now we have two different of movement. Okay, if you simulate this drilling, I have the first, this orientation for two holes, and automatic now change the orientation and go in the other orientation and directly work the other hole. Okay, so for finish our process, we try to create also a strategy on a curves. Okay, for example, I want to create a contouring on these 3D curves. Okay, for example, to create a chamfer. Okay, create a new operation. Okay, for example, the name is contouring one. okay, and select my curve machine modes, okay. Go in my wizard, okay. Here it's possible to select a different kind of strategy, contouring, okay, but also, for example, pocketing or flattening, because in these models normally use these for create the typical 2D two-axis strategy, okay, for 2D curve and so on. In our approaches, I select my contouring, okay. It's possible to select also, for example, the deep of my operation, and it's possible to select also the step of for complete my operation. It's possible to select also the size. Other very important option is possible to select here the position of the tool or respect the curve. In this case, it's possible to put inside the tool inside my curve or outside, okay. Or, like in this case, with the center of tool directly on my curve, okay? Here, I select my curves, in this case, this 3D curve, okay? Select these and confirm. Normally, it's possible to select also more curve in the same strategy, okay? In this case, only one. And go in the next page, in the next page of our wizard, in this case, next page is the possibility to put inside, for example, our Z clearance plane, okay, and the distance, the security distance before from rapid movement to work movement. Here on the bottom of this window is possible to select and create different kind of leading the approach or this approach. It's possible to work, for example, in a vertical directly on my curves, or with a ramp with the angle, or for example directly with an arc or line tangential to the first point on my curve, okay, and it's possible to create a different approach respect to this approach. Okay, in this case, it's possible to work directly in a vertical in my curves. Okay, go in next step. My tool, for example, I selected my tool. I don't know, like ball tool with I don't know 8 millimeter diameter. Okay, go in last windows with my whole plane select and calculate my curve. So, for example, in this case, my curve, if you start the simulation, I have the very easy and simple 3D movement, my tool on my curve, okay? Okay, but for example, in this case, I have a 5-axis machine, and I want to create this kind of strategy, the same, but with the tool that stay for each point, for example, perpendicular to my parts, okay? And so, we come back in our strategy, okay, with the right mouse on my list, okay? And it's possible to activate the 5-axis option, okay? And inside here, it's possible, for example, select my operation with the tool axis perpendicular to select a surface like this image, okay? It's possible to select also the tool axis parallel to select surfaces. For example, in this case, it's very, very good if you have, for example, to cut your part in 5-axis. It's very good for plastic material cutting market or for carbon fiber or also in a wood market. Normally use very good this because it's very fast to create these. Automatically, the tool go with your side parallel to the surface select. Or it's possible to manually create with the segment, orientate manually for each point my tool. Possible to draw a segment on my line and manage this manually. Okay. In our case, we go in a tool axis perpendicular to select surface and click OK, recalculate my created, okay, so just a second, I forget to select here my surface, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, but in this case I came to select all my part because automatically RNC recognize the surface that is near to my curve. Okay, click OK, activate and recalculate. Okay, now if you simulate my toolpath, okay, I have this kind of toolpath. Okay, for each point, I come back. Okay, for each point, my tool is perpendicular to the surface. It's a special movement 5-axis continuous. Okay. So we have finished our approaches, okay? We have finished our strategy, for example, but need the last step to create a post-processor for my machine tool, okay? We have different possibility. For example, if we want to post-process only one of my strategy, I can to select these, for example, these, okay? And put in my mind bar directly on this command, okay? Put here. And create automatically my toolpath, okay, in this case with the ISO language, okay, standard language, my toolpath, okay. But, and now you see, now my strategy is green, okay. Okay, this strategy I finished, I really finished. But if you want to, for example, create one post-processor for more strategy, for example, I want to select this and also this, because I have the automatic to change, I want to create only one file and so on, I'm supposed to select in my list the strategy and put on my command. Or if you want to select all directly, all my approaches, okay, select here on my bar, this icon, okay, when is put here red, now when I put here post-processor all the strategy inside my process, my file, okay? But when I put here, okay, now compare these windows, that is possible to have two possibility. If you want to create only one file to go on machine with the automatic toolpath and so on, or if you want to create the post-processor for all my process, but automatically split for each strategy. You have one file for each strategy, but created in only one time, okay? So, for example, it's possible to change the kind of post-processor because in my company I have different kind of milling machine, different kind of control. For example, if I put, in this case, on my tree in one strategy, for example, in this finishing, I go in a post-processor, okay, and here it's possible to select from my company list for my machine, for example, another kind of machines, for example, Heidner language, okay? Select these, okay? You want to calculate the same strategy, okay? I create another post-processor with another language, okay? So it's possible to select the kind of machine, the kind of post-processor after to create all my approaches, okay? It's not necessary to recalculate all my strategy, all my approaches, and so on. Okay, so we arrive at the end of our simulation, okay? I want to show you another special option of RNC. It's very, very important. Is a customization of interface. What means? For example, normally the contouring strategy on a curve, using different market, using different kind of material. And so for each kind of company or market, normally the customer use 2 parameter or 20 parameter, okay? So in this wizard, we have the possibility to select, to hidden or show only parameter. And so you can to create your layout, your custom interface for to have more speed or easy to use this, okay? This is very, very important, this part. Another possibility is, for example, we suppose in a roughing strategy, okay, in a 3D strategy, Normally, I start to create before I initial the stock part, the main parameters, and then I select the tool. There are many customers that prefer to change this sequence to select before a tool and then other parameter. Okay, no problem. And it's possible to go in our configuration wizard, okay, here. And for example, it's possible to select tool on first position. Okay, save this. If you come back in my strategy, now the first windows on my wizard is the tool. Okay. Other possibility, for example, also in a roughing machine, for example, this is the main parameter, but inside this strategy, there are many, many parameters to configure this kind of strategy. But in this case, for example, I hidden this because I prefer to don't never change this parameter or don't need this. But if you now need this other parameter, it's possible in a configuration, for example, show the advanced parameters, okay, confirm. If I come back in my strategy, now compare another tab, another window, with other parameter that is possible to change or create my new layout and so on. This is very important because this is a focus of the RenewC. It's possible to use in every kind of situation and to have always the best interface, the very easy and fast interface to work. Okay, so I finish my presentation, our webinar. If you have the answer about RenewC question, info, please you can to write directly in the go to webinar Naomi a question. I try to answer you this. Okay.
Okay, Andrea, thank you. And we can take just a minute for the question, if there is some question. And we want to remember you that the registration of this webinar will be available on our YouTube channel, Chain System Industry, in a few days. For the upcoming event, you can find very soon the schedule of the next week on our website and our social network.
Okay. Okay, no problem. If you have a question or if you want more information, please send me an email, this email, training@sinsystem.com. And I thank you very, very much for your interest. Thank you very
See
much.
See you next event.
Have a nice weekend and bye-bye.
Bye.